Great. I'm Andrew Shtulman. I'm in the Departments of Psychology and Cognitive Science at Occidental College, and I study cognitive development, in particular conceptual change and how we learn scientific beliefs and religious beliefs. All right, so how can we create a more scientifically literate public? There's been decades of research that indicate that the average person holds intuitive theories of the world that do not accord with our modern scientific understanding of the world, and educators are paying attention to this research, so they're now creating curricula that challenge the intuitive theories before introducing the new scientific theories. And I think that's great, and it's making a difference in science education. But now there's new findings that are emerging that I don't think the education community has yet to embrace, which is that intuitive theories of the world never seem to go away. So even if you learn the correct scientific understanding, you still have this residual intuitive understanding that can be primed in the right context. If you're reasoning under any kind of time constraints, you'll default to the intuitive understanding rather than the scientific understanding. And so I think that beyond just acknowledging intuitive theories as a way of introducing scientific theories, we also need to help students recognize that the intuitive theories are still there, and that there are going to be certain situations that prime those theories, and that we need to be better at being reflective about the kinds of explanations we're providing, the kinds of solutions we're offering to a problem, whether or not those explanations and those solutions are based in intuition or they're based in science. And so, in short, I think that it's great that we're acknowledging intuitive theories, and some of our supernatural explanations of the world go along with the intuitive stuff. But beyond just acknowledging them, we also have to train people to be reflective of their online reasoning and recognize when intuition holds sway and when science holds sway.